today, the Tampa Bay Rays, who are playing their first game of the season today. They tweeted out, today is opening day, which means it's a great day to arrest the killers of Breonna Taylor. I want to get your reaction to that because that is huge.
Yeah, I love it, man. And watching the Nationals and Yankees take knees yesterday, I love it all. But, you know, to Jalen's point again, I'm agreeing with Jalen this whole morning. I don't want to make the person who's selling yellow paint rich. I'm tired of people painting streaks Black Lives Matter. The things on the back of your jerseys, that's dope. That's cool. But, like, let's have systemic change. Let's make sure people go to school where heating and air aren't falling apart, where their infrastructure is not falling apart. Let's make sure that you have Black folk in your C-suite, not just, you know, working in your companies. Let's make sure you have Black folk on your boards. Let's talk about incorporating this movement into our everyday lives so that the conversations I have to have with my daughter, who is taking her driver's test today, so fingers crossed, the conversation I have to have with her as a Black child is not one that white parents have to have with their children. And all we want to do is get to a point where our children can be free. So I am proud of the tweets. I love the social justice messaging, the streets being painted, the statues coming down. But I'm like LeBron and Jalen. I demand much more.
How long do you see these very, you know, out there pushes for awareness lasting? I mean, we see all the sports leagues doing different things before the game, during the game. How long do you see this lasting?
Oh, can I take this one?
Yeah.
Please do.
America,
I don't have
get ready for this, America. Forever.
Good.
Forever. That toothpaste ain't going back in the tube. That silence, that being trampled over and accepting systemic racism and economic being taken to our knees based on how our community's being treated, we're not going to be silent anymore. And Bakar, you just reminded me of something. I've been biting my nails the last 2 weeks as the founder of a charter high school of underprivileged kids when I see political figures on television ignoring science. I work in sports, and I'm watching the games. No fans there. Okay, we canceling GOP conventions, but if underprivileged students don't go to school, we're going to cut their funding. How about that? We're at a time where schools need more money because of what we're dealing with right now in pandemic. Those levels of threats are out there. So it's very important that when we get this leverage and or these reparations, as I'm calling them, we ain't going back. So if you think Black Lives Matter in the middle of the street means something, wait till it get on a building. That's what we waiting for. Wait till it's on the side of a casino. That's what we're going for. We're not just trying to have NBA players and NFL players be contributors out on the field and on the court. What about ownership? Let's check out what those meetings look like and the diversity in those meetings and amongst presidents, that is amongst general managers and amongst coaches. So I think now, because we were brought to this country initially to entertain, that was a part of it, and labor. And you know what we realized? We could get rich from it. And you know what we did? We moved to the suburbs. And now we got a voice. And we gonna keep using it every chance we get.
But not only that, I just want to say that young kids are getting it too. I remember Chuba down at Oklahoma State speaking his mind, the running back from Oklahoma State. McCore Maker going to Howard University. You know, I have my South Carolina State sweatshirt on today. I hope that Mikey Williams goes to South Carolina State or Morehouse. I mean, you're starting to see the sea of change because young people, and every ounce of change we've ever had in this country has been because of young people. But they're now speaking up. They're speaking out. They're using their voice. I live next to Stephon Gilmore, and we had these conversations all the time about how to use your voice. It's so powerful to watch right now. So when is this going to stop? It's never going to stop, because what we're seeing right now is a new generation, the next generation of leaders, thinkers, athletes, and change agents. And I'm just proud to be here. And we're just as an American and just as patriotic as the next person, because we're pushing this country to be better than it was and to be better than it is.
I want to make one point about Breonna Taylor's incident, that let's imagine a hypothetical world in which these three people are brought to justice and they are arrested and charged. unlikely to be convicted. You have to remember that part. And let's not celebrate these things as the end of the war, but just one small step in a long walk towards eliminating systematic racism and social injustice. Because there's a part of me that fears that they will arrest these three individuals, and then that will take a little bit of air out of the balloon in this fight against social injustice, especially amongst my white people. What do you think about that, Bakari?
That's powerful. You know, you said something that I wholeheartedly agree with, arrest or not justice, but you got to start the process somewhere. Yeah, I don't believe, I have a hard time believing that Derek Chauvin is going to be convicted, right? I'm not someone out here who is a lawyer. I do criminal defense work all the time. I know how hard it is to convict cops. And so you're right. We can't take these crumbs and be celebratory. But I will tell you this, in 401 years since black folk have been in this country, sometimes we have to find things to have hope in. Sometimes we have to have a reason to keep our faith. And so I understand those moments of celebration. I understand those moments of pride. But as I said it earlier, we've made a lot of progress, but we still have such a far way to go.
Well, such important conversation. So happy we're having them, especially on this platform. So Bakari, thank you so much. New York Times bestselling author of My Vanishing Country. So make sure you check out his book. Bakari, thank you so much for your time. We appreciate you.
Thank you all.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.